Hi everyone, my name is Larissa. I'm a neurobiologist and a person with Charcot-Marie tooth disease. This video is the first in a series called Supplements and CMT. My conclusions on this topic, just like any other topic, are based on scientific evidence, not subjective opinions. Therefore, today I'm going to cover if there is any scientific evidence suggesting that taking creatine as a supplement can help CMT. But first of all, let me apologize for this view. It's a weird angle, I know, and it's just because I'm moving from Kyoto to Tokyo. I'm currently living in Japan, so there is a bit of a mess at my place. Apologies for that, but let's move on to the subject. First of all, what is creatine? Creatine is a molecule that is naturally produced in our cells and is required for them to produce energy. The concentration of creatine is particularly high in skeletal and cardiac muscles, as well as in the brain, which are called high demand energy tissues. It was discovered in 1832 by a French scientist, Michel Eugène Chevreul, who extracted it from meat and named it after the Greek word for meat, kreas. Creatine. The way it works is creatine is produced by our body from the amino acids glycine and arginine. Then creatine is taken up by tissues with high energy demands like muscle cells and is stored as phosphocreatine, which is used to rapidly synthesize ATP from ADP. Now, ATP is adenosine triphosphate. This is like an energy currency for our body. So you can remember this as the energy molecule in our body. Our muscles have readily available fuel, which is ATP, but it is in short supply. And to get more fuel, ADP is used. So from the names, you can already guess that unlike ATP, which has three phosphate groups, ADP has only two. Therefore, it needs to get one more to be an efficient fuel source to convert into ATP. That's why ADP needs phosphocreatine. Phosphocreatine gives away its phosphate group to ADP, which then turns into ATP and can now provide energy to the muscle cells. So here you can see on this picture what I've just explained and why we need phosphocreatine for energy production in the muscle cells and in some other cells as well. In this process that we've just covered, an enzyme called creatine kinase or creatine phosphokinase, this stands for the same molecule, for the same enzyme, plays an important role. So CPK or CK catalyzes the reaction from creatine and adenosine triphosphate, ATP, to phosphocreatine and ADP, which happens during periods of low energy. And I'm mentioning that because many people actually on Facebook and otherwise, many of my subscribers have asked me, oh, I had my blood drawn and my CK, creatine kinase levels, were high. What does it mean? Is it connected to CMT or not? Well, it might be, because clinically the creatine kinase level in the blood is a measure of damage of tissue enriched with the enzymes. So if your creatine kinase level is high, it might indicate the damage to the muscle tissue. And indeed, this enzyme is elevated in the case of muscle or heart damages. This could be a result of heart attack, muscle injury, intense exercise, kidney injury, or neuromuscular disorders. So yes, some people with CMT might have elevated levels of CK or CPK, and it might indicate, and it might be associated with CMT. It might be caused by CMT. But as far as I know, CK is not used as a biomarker, so it's probably not consistently high across people with CMT. And actually, I had my CK level checked once only in 2017, and it was fine. So yeah, it's not a reliable biomarker for people with CMT. So So overall, coming back to creatine, you can think about it as an energy buffer or energy reservoir in our cells. And now that you know what role creatine plays in the cells, it should come as no surprise that people have been exploring the idea of supplementing creatine to boost its content in the muscles and therefore increasing the muscle's performance. Not only people with neuromuscular diseases, but also just healthy people to improve their kind of sports performance. They have been trying to explore creatine as a supplement this way. And indeed, creatine is one of the most popular supplements taken by sports enthusiasts. So the belief is that by increasing the muscle's ability to resynthesize ATP, the energy molecule that we just discussed, creatine supplementation is expected to aid muscle function. So this has been the theory, and some experiments have shown that this is true. In cells, in animals. But when it comes to studies on humans, not everything is so clear-cut as usual. So there is really no clear answer to the question, does creatine supplementation improve exercise performance? Or to many other creatine-related questions. In fact, one team published a paper in 2022. The team of scientists, they published a paper and they conducted a review on creatine. And the way they write the abstract for the paper is, although there are over 500 peer-reviewed publications involving creatine supplementation, it is somewhat surprising that questions regarding the efficacy and safety of creatine still remain. These include, but are not limited to, and then they list 12 questions which still don't have answers, although there are already 500 peer-reviewed papers, publications that some of them are studies that were conducted on people, and there is still not clear answer. Why? You can ask, and the answer to this question, I think, is relevant to almost any question in physiology, in medicine. It's because everything is really context specific. So when we're thinking about supplementing creatine, which population of people are we looking at? Are these healthy people? How athletic they are? How well trained they are? What is their age? What is their sex? What kind of training are they even doing? Is it strength training? Is it endurance training? Is it some other kind of training? Is it all of this? So there are so many parameters that should be kind of taken into account and that can influence how creatine influences the body. And because I'm covering CMT specifically, right, Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease, and if supplementation with creatine helps with Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease, of course, we must think about creatine supplementation in this context, in the context of CMT. And then it becomes even more complicated because, just like I always highlight, CMT is a very heterogeneous disease. I don't even think that all the CMT diseases should be defined as one CMT disease because there are such different mutations in such different genes, which does lead to the same more or less symptoms, but even that is really heterogeneous. People with CMT have very different symptoms sometimes and very different progression of the disease. So even that, even within CMT, we should think about the specific context. Was the study done on a specific type of CMT? What was the progression of the disease? What was the age of the people, of the subjects that were involved in the study, and so on. But anyway, if we come back a little bit to the studies conducted in healthy people, what does the evidence suggest? From my former colleague from Lifespan.io, I used to write articles for this amazing organization. Check it out. Steve, he was my colleague at the time, and he wrote a really nice overview of creatine supplementation and its benefits or side effects. So please check it out. Tells exactly the same. There is no clear answer to the question if creatine supplementation even improves physical performance or not, because there are studies saying it does, there are studies that saying it doesn't. For example, one study showed that both creatine and placebo allowed men to do more squats. So they were just comparing men doing squats and seeing if one group or the other could do more squats. They didn't see any difference between the two groups. There is some evidence that creatine may have benefits for various health issues, including metabolic and brain disorders like epilepsy, traumatic brain injury, depression, diseases like Parkinson's and Huntington's. But again, each of these we need to consider separately, and we need to read all the research on each of these conditions and then maybe make some conclusions. But again, the conclusions will most likely be very unclear. And Steve also writes about one study that enrolled people with long COVID symptoms, and these people were given creatine supplementation, and indeed after taking the supplementation, after taking creatine, people with long COVID symptoms experienced less fatigue. They were less tired. So in that regard, maybe creatine might help with long COVID symptoms. So let's go to CMT. Well, I managed to find only two papers about creatine supplementation in people with CMT, and they were published long ago in 2004 and 2006 by the same group of researchers. So just the fact that already 20 years have passed since then and no other evidence has been collected, no other studies have been conducted showing that there is any beneficial outcome from creatine supplementation in CMT already tells you that probably it's not beneficial. So, but let's look into more detail what these studies were about. So in the former study, 2004, 20 patients with CMT, 9 men and 11 women, mean age was 45 years, and it was mostly CMT1A, so they consumed 5 grams of creatine per day, and it was creatine monohydrate. By the way, this is the type of creatine that people that is recommended. If you are taking the supplement, then you'd better take creatine monohydrate. So these 20 patients, they were either taking creatine or placebo while participating in resistance training for 12 weeks. So participants used adjustable wrist and ankle weights. So this you can buy easily from Amazon, for example. In my previous video, I was showing you what I have at my apartment, in my home gym. And they also used the therapeutic squeeze ball. They were exercising 3 times per week. What the researchers checked was energy metabolites, muscle fiber type and size, strength, and timed activities of daily living. So basically they were looking at if there were any kind of molecular changes, like cellular other changes after creatine supplementation, if there were changes in strength, muscle strength, and if people could do activities of daily living better. So these include rising from a chair without using the arms, rising from a supine position on an examination table, and stair climbing. Okay, and what did they find out? They found out that creatine was not beneficial. Literally, there was no difference between CMT patients who were exercising and taking creatine and exercising and not taking creatine. But they did see the improvement in all of these patients. So what does it tell you? Exercising is good. You should exercise. You should do strength exercising. But creatine supplementation is not going to help. So that's the easy conclusion. And now if we talk a little bit more about the actual training program that these participants went through, it was a 12-week home-based resistance training program. As I already mentioned, they used adjustable wrist and ankle weights and the therapeutic squeeze ball. They were using 3 sets. They were doing 3 sets of varying repetitions, 3 times per week for elbow and knee flexion and extension. The amount of weight used for the flexion extension exercises was based on each subject's baseline strength. So, even if you're very weak, if you've never exercised, it's still possible to understand what your baseline strength is, then to start from training at 40% approximately of like your maximum capacity, and then increase the load a little bit. So that's basically a common approach for exercising, and it works for CMT patients as well. It's just that for CMT patients, most likely what is needed is to make the load a little less than for healthy people. Yeah, so you can read the paper and see what the actual training program was in more detail, but this is what it was. They were increasing the load kind of periodically every week. And then if the person with CMT could not perform the exercises, they were kind of going back a little bit. So we can say, I can basically finish the video right now and make the conclusion that nobody should be taking creatine if they have CMT. However, in the follow-up study, right, I mentioned that there were two studies. In the follow-up study of 2006, the scientists, the same group of scientists, they kind of looked at the same subjects, and they showed that creatine supplementation alters the specific muscle protein content. That is, it increases specific myosin heavy chain contractile proteins. So these are known as motor proteins. They are involved in transportation within muscle cells. And so the scientists showed that at the molecular level, indeed there are some changes after creatine supplementation. But what the hell does it mean? Nobody really knows. Is it a good thing? Is it a bad thing? It remains to be shown. So again, conclusion is, if you have CMT, there is no evidence that creatine supplementation can help. There is some evidence that creatine helps exercise performance, physical performance for people, for healthy people, especially if they do high intensity strength training. But if you have CMT, most likely you're not doing this kind of training, and it's actually not recommended. High intensity strength training is not recommended for people with CMT. Usually moderate intensity training is recommended for people with CMT, not to increase the inflammation too much and not to get a trauma. So because of these two reasons, usually high intensity training is not recommended to people with CMT. So unless you do high intensity training, which you probably don't because you have CMT, supplementing with creatine is not gonna work. Unless you're a vegetarian, that's another thing. And that's what I want to convince people with CMT not to do, not to be vegetarians. Because if you're a vegetarian, it's just so much easier to be deficient in specific nutrients, in specific molecules, including creatine. If you have CMT, if you're a vegetarian, if you do high intensity training, okay, knock yourself out, and probably you should be taking creatine supplements after talking to your doctor. If you are not doing any of those things, most likely it's not gonna help you anyway. And I have never taken creatine supplements. I don't want to try. I'm not planning to try. I just do my exercise, and it definitely makes me feel better and helps me keep my muscle strength, at least to some extent. Of course, because of CMT, muscle atrophy is inevitable anyway, but exercise is the best way to keep the muscles going. Okay, that's it for today. Next video is going to be about the next supplement we're going to discuss, which is a secret for now. But please subscribe, like this video, share this video with your CMT friends, and yeah, let's make our decisions based on scientific evidence, not hearsay. So I hope this approach helps you and appeals to you, and if it does, please leave a comment below. Bye bye.